We need wisdom to occupy. We've been talking about possessing the promises of God, and in order for us to possess the promise of God, we require God's guidance for Him to show us how to move forward and how to fight every enemy. Now I'm going to repeat this scripture, Deuteronomy 1:21. Behold, the Lord your God has set the land before you. Go up and take possession of it, just as the Lord, the God of your fathers, has spoken to you. Do not fear or be dismayed. So the instruction and encouragement that goes out to the Israelites to possess the promised land is this, where God is encouraging them to move forward, to move ahead, and to step into their territory. But for them to do it, I'm sure the leaders, both Moses and Joshua, needed the wisdom of God, because as they were moving towards the promised land, they found battles, they found enemies, they found regions where just going up with a sword wouldn't help. And so we see the unusual interventions of God. We see the miracles of God. We see the wisdom of God upon these leaders. I mean, who would have thought that Joshua would lead the people through the Jordan River, where the flooding Jordan River would somehow make way for the people to walk walk through it? And in the same way, who would have thought that walking around Jericho would bring down the walls? All of this is the wisdom of God, where every battle and every enemy requires a new strategy. And in the same way, in our lives, we're not talking about just physical land here, but we're talking about our spiritual promises, our inheritance. And in fact, one of the greatest inheritances that God wants for us to have is souls. He wants us to win souls for the kingdom of God. But is it going to be the same? We know that the gospel is the power of God unto those who are being saved. But how do we take this gospel out? How do we bring this gospel to different communities? We need the wisdom of God. No, we need the Holy Spirit to direct us and show us the most effective ways in which we can bring the gospel to people. And our heart, our inheritance, this land is our inheritance, as God says to His Son in Psalms 2:8, I will give you the nations for your inheritance. How to get the nations for our inheritance? We need God's wisdom. We need God directing us. And it's only then we will be able to possess. And even today, if we're struggling and saying, God, there are all these things that You've called us to do, called me to do, and I really don't know how to get this started, or at this point, God, I don't know what is the next idea. Well, the Bible says that we have the mind of God. We can depend on the Holy Spirit to bring us revelation. We can depend on the gifts of the Spirit to operate in our lives, where the word of knowledge, the gift of discerning of spirits, the word of wisdom can operate in us, and God can give us a new strategy. He can do great things in and through our lives. And definitely, if we walk in this manner of being led by the word and led by the Spirit, we can occupy all that God has for us, and we will have the wisdom to do it. And every battle that the Lord leads us to fight, He hands the enemy over to us, and indeed we walk in triumphant victory in Christ Jesus. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank You, God, that You always lead us in triumphant victory. Father, we ask, O God, for Your wisdom in every area of our lives. God, You will grant us the understanding and the revelation that we need to break through from the place where we are, God, into a broader ground, Father God. Thank You that You establish, Father God, our steps. And Father, we honor You for that, Lord. We thank You and we praise You. In Jesus' name we pray.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.